I've read some forums here and there. Why kip ash at all? Or why make a practical model when you can just build it in CG? And really, the honest to goodness answer to that is Titanfall walks, and Titanfall 2 walk a very fine line design wise and trying to feel honest. The source material you're using keeps the design honest. You know, real world objects, they're never perfect. They're always a little bit crooked and stuff. It just looks a little bit more real that way. Because you're not working in a digital world and you're bound by physical rules, even though it's 1/6 scale, it kind of, you get these happy accidents. You know, this part's imbalanced. This arm's a little bit bigger. This ear sticks out a little more over here. Or this helmet's a little bit crooked, or the strap's doing this or that. It just adds a little bit of realism to things. You know, if we go back to Titanfall 1, we're at a point in the process where we're trying to figure out what to do. So the artists were doing a lot of 2D concepts and, you know, traditional concepting and stuff. And so it seemed like you could get a lot more done a lot faster if we kind of went with an old kitbash style. So if you're familiar with Titanfall, this was the very first maquette that we did. And actually, I can point to it as almost the birth of why Titanfall has giant robots in it. You know, this started out as a dive suit. It was supposed to be some power suit that these characters were gonna go in and kind of clear out aliens or whatever. And then one of the designers and I were hanging out one day. He says, how about we put a little character on there and see what happens? And we had an aha moment. We went in and talked to the other designers, and you know, they were in the middle of trying to figure out what Titanfall was in the first place. And then what you saw in Titanfall 1 kind of evolved out of, you know, the Atlas Titan evolved out of this. So what you're about to see is a time lapse that I did of this maquette right here, which is a lightweight pilot from the game, and pretty much this character is everything. It's vacuum forming with a little vacuum form machine. It's 3D printing. It's kitbash. It's wire work with it's tons of dremeling. And I think, I don't know if it's in the time lapse, but there might be a frame in there of me actually stabbing my finger pretty good, and then learning how to use glue as a band-aid. So enjoy.